Hello students, welcome to all four e-learning classes. So today we are discussing some problems related to the electric field and motion of the charged particle in a electric field. Okay, see in that first one here, two charges 50 microcoulombs and 100 microcoulombs are separated by a distance of 0.6 meters. The intensity of electric field at midpoint between them. Okay, now what is here given? Two charges, one is 50 microcoulomb, Q1 is equals to 50 microcoulomb and Q2 is equals to 100 microcoulomb. What is the distance? They are a part of 0.6 meters, 0.6 meters apart with each other. Now what is the resultant intensity of electric field at midpoint? Midpoint means exactly the distance of the second charge from the center is 0.3 meters. It is also 0.3 meters. Now what are two charges are positive only? The Q1 is positive charge, Q2 is also positive charge. First of all, find the electric field intensity by this first charge. Or what is the formula, what is its direction? Radially outwards, let us take this is E1. What is E1 value? E1 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R square. No need to write R1 square, R2 square. The distance of the point, midpoint is same from the first charge and second charge. Okay? And what about the intensity of electric field at the point P by the second charge? Let it be E2. What is E2? E2 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 by, what is distance again? R square. Now if you are observing, what is, this is also positive. What is the direction? Radially outwards. This is the direction of E2 here. E1, E2 are opposite directions. And what is here? Q2 is greater than Q1. So obviously E2 is greater than E1. Therefore, actually what net intensity of electric field we may write, E2 is equals to here E2 minus E1. Because they are opposite in direction, and which one is greater here? E2 is greater than E1. Okay, distance is same, but the here charge 50 microcoulomb, here 100 microcoulomb. So what is the value of E2? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 by R square minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R square. In these two terms, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by R square is common. What is the remaining? Q2 minus Q1. What is the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is? The 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value is 9 into 10 power 9. 1 by R square. 1 by R square. What is R value? 0.3 meters here. 0.3 means you may write 3 into 10 power minus 1 whole square. Okay? Q2 minus Q1, 100 minus 50 microcoulomb. So into 10 power minus 6. Microcoulombs convert into coulombs. Okay? That is 9 into 10 power 9, 3 square 9 into 10 power minus 2, 100 minus 50, 50 into 10 power minus 6. Okay, now what is 9 9, get cancel, minus 9, plus 9 plus 2 plus 11, 50 into 10 power minus 6 10 power 11, that is 50 into 10 power 5 or 5 into 10 power 6 5 into 10 power 6 newton per coulomb. Okay, what is the value? Is 5 into 10 power 6 newton per coulomb. Okay, If these two charges also equal magnitude, what is the resultant electric field at the center becomes zero. Equal and opposite, they cancel. But here the charges are not in equal magnitude, so that we get a resultant electric field intensity, which is 5 into 10 power 6 Newton per coulomb. Okay. So this is about the first problem. Two charges separating by certain distance. Okay, 0.6 meters. We are calculating the electric field intensity at midpoint of the two charges. The value will be 5 into 10 power 6 Newton per coulomb. Okay. Next. See the second one, a charged particle of mass m charge q is suspended from a string and placed in the uniform electric field of intensity E. Okay, then what is the angle made by the string with the vertical at equilibrium position? What is a charged particle of mass m? Let us take a charged particle of mass m charge q suspended by a string. Let us take this is a string and here a charged particle is suspended. What is its mass is m and charge is q. Suspended in the electric field. Let us take this is a electric field. Whenever the electric field is acts on these charged particle, the force acting on the positive charge V is in the direction of electric field. So that the string moves along these directions. It moves like this. The electric force is along this direction. Okay. Now, at equilibrium state, what is Mg is acts vertically downwards. And tension in the string is along the length of the string. Tension in the string is along the length of the string. Okay. T. Now, here asking what is the angle made by the string with a vertical. We should find theta value here. Okay. We need to find theta value. So, if it is internal angle T, theta, resolving these theta into components. What is the horizontal component? This is T cos theta. And what should be the vertical component? This is T sin theta. And what is Fe? Electric force is in the direction of force. Fe is equals to EQ. Okay. Now asking, what is the angle made by the... Okay, we need to find this theta value here. Okay. Angle made by the string with a vertical. So let us take this, extend this value here. If it is theta, here also you may take theta. Okay, it is Fe, here also it is Fe. Okay. Now, what is the formula of, this is a right angle triangle or not? This is a right angle triangle. Can we write like this, tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent? Tan theta is equals to opposite by adjacent. Okay. Listen here. Tan theta is equals to, from this triangle, from this right angle triangle, tan theta is equals to, what is Fe? By Mg. Okay. What is Fe value? EQ by Mg. Therefore, what is theta is equals to? Tan inverse of EQ by Mg. Okay, this is the angle subtended by the string with a vertical. Theta is equals to tan inverse of EQ by Mg. Or we have one more, we can do this problem in another method. So listen here, without extending this value, at equilibrium state, they given at equilibrium state. At equilibrium state, what is T sin theta is equals to Fe. At equilibrium state, what is T sin theta is equals to EQ. And what is T cos theta is equals to MG. Let us take, this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Now equation number 1 divided by equation number 2. T sin theta by T cos theta is equals to EQ by MG. Okay, TT get cancelled. Tan theta is equals to EQ by MG. Therefore, what is theta is equals to? Tan inverse of EQ by MG. Okay, this is the other method. At equilibrium state, the component of the tension T cos theta is balanced by MG. T sin theta is balanced by electric force. Then what is the angle subtended by the string with a vertical is theta is equals to tan inverse of EQ by MG. Here, a charged particle of mass m, charge q suspended by the string in a uniform electric field. Then what is the angle made by the string with a vertical means, which is equals to tan inverse of EQ by MG. So this is about the second one. Okay, next to go through the third problem. See third one. If a proton of mass m charge e, a proton of mass m and charge e, a proton of mass m charge small e is released from the rest, is released from rest means what is initial velocity? Zero. Released from rest means initial velocity is zero. In a uniform electric field strength capital E. What is electric field strength is capital E. Electric field strength capital E. Okay. Then the time taken by it to travel the distance D from D in the field. Asking time taken. Time taken by the charged particle to travel a distance d. A proton of mass m charge e released from rest in a uniform electric field strength of e. Then what is the time taken by the proton to travel a distance d in the field? Okay. See here. Whenever the charged particle is at rest, what is initial velocity? Zero. And what is the charge here denoted by E? Now what is the expression for acceleration due to electric field? A is equals to F by M. F is equal to EQ, where Q be the charge here, but charge denoted by small e, EE by M. Okay. So we have an expression. What is from the equation of motion? From the equation of motion, what is the formula? S is equals to ut plus half at square. S is equals to ut plus half at square. What is S? Is a distance d here. Okay. What is initial velocity released from rest? U0 into something 0 plus 1 by 2. What is A? Let it be A only, t square. So what we will get here, d is equals to half at square, 2d is equals to at square, t square is equals to 2d by a, t is equals to root over 2d by a. Now substitute the value of a. Okay, t is equals to 2d by, what is instead of a? Capital E, small e by m. That implies 2dm by capital E, small e. okay? So this is about the time taken by the proton to travel a distance d in a uniform electric field strength E when it is released from rest. What is the time taken? T is equals to under root of 2dm by capital E into small e. Okay, this is about the third one. Now go through the fourth problem. Okay, see, infinite number of charges each of magnitude q are placed on the x-axis. Infinite number of charges each of magnitude q are placed on the x-axis at a distance of 1, 2, 4, 8, and so on meters from the origin. Okay, then the electric field intensity at the origin is, let us take this is an x-axis. Okay, x-axis, here what is x is equals to 0, number of charges are kept at a distance of, at x is equals to 1 meter, x is equals to 2 meters, x is equals to 4 meters, x is equals to 8 meters and so on. Infinite number of charges are kept on the the distance 1, 2, 4, 8 and so on meters. Identical charges are kept, all are magnitude q only and all are positive charges only. Infinite number of charges, infinite number of charges each of magnitude q are placed on the x-axis at a distance of 1 meter, 2 meters, 4 meters, 8 meters and so on. What is the resultant electric field intensity at the origin? Okay, all are positive charges only. See, let us take here E1 be the intensity of electric field at the x is equal to 0 by the first charge. Can we write like this? This is, if it is E1, this is a direction of E1 radially outwards. What is the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by R1 square. Similarly, E2 be the intensity of electric field at the x is equal to 0 by the second charge. E2 is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 is Q, Q2 is also Q by R2 square. The distance only different here. And similarly, what is E3 also? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Charge remains same, so let it be Q by R3 square. Okay? E4 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, Q by R4 square. Now we need resultant intensity of electric field, net intensity of electric field. Okay, not only by these, like that you may get E5, E6 and so on. All are positive charges only. This is a E2 direction, this is a direction of E3. This is a direction of E4. All are towards the origin. The net intensity of electric field is vector sum of the individual intensities of electric field. E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar plus E4 bar and so on up to infinite. Okay. Now substitute the values. E net is equals to, what is E1 bar value? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R1 square. What is the value of E2? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R2 square. And what is the value of E3? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R3 square. Like up to so on infinite number of terms. Okay? Now, in among all these terms, what is a Q by 4 pi epsilon naught is common? What is remaining? 1 by R1 square plus 1 by R2 square plus 1 by R3 square plus 1 by R4 square and so on up to infinite number of terms. Okay? क्यू बै फोर पै एप्सिलॉन नॉट ऑफ 1 बै आर वन स्क्वेयर प्लस 1 बै आर टू स्क्वेयर प्लस 1 बै आर थ्री स्क्वेयर प्लस 1 बै आर फोर स्क्वेयर एंड सो ऑन इनफिनिट दट इज इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू बै फोर पै एप्सिलॉन नॉट इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू बै फोर पै एप्सिलॉन नॉट वाट इज आर वन वैल्यू Here the first charge is there at a distance of 1 meter from the origin. Second charge is there at a distance of 2 meters from the origin. And third charge is there at a distance of 4 meter. Fourth charge is at a distance of 8 meters and so on. So R1 value is 1 meter. R2 value is 2 meters. R3 value is 4 meters. And R4 is 8 meters. So 1 by 1 square. प्लस 1 बाय 2 स्क्वेयर प्लस 1 बाय 4 स्क्वेयर प्लस 1 बाय 8 स्क्वेयर एंड सो ऑन अप टू इनफिनिट नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स ओके दैट इज ई इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू बाय 4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट 1 बाय 1 स्क्वेयर मींस 1 प्लस 1 बाय 4 2 स्क्वेयर 4 4 स्क्वेयर 16 8 स्क्वेयर 64 and so on infinite number of terms okay now e is equals to q by 4 pi epsilon naught okay if you are observing these equation what is they are in geometrical progression the first term is a is equal to 1 and r is equal to 1 by 4 okay we have one expression s infinity is equals to a by 1 minus r What is a value here? 1 by 1 minus 1 by r 1 by 4. That is, e is equals to q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by 4 minus 1, 3 by 4. Okay? Now what happens here? The 4, 4 get cancelled here. It comes like this, e is equals to 4 q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 3. Now if 4, 4 get cancelled, what is the answer finally? Q by 3 pi epsilon naught. Okay? The answer is Q by 3 pi epsilon naught. If infinite number of identical charges each of magnitude Q are arranged on the x-axis at a distance of 1 meters, 2 meters, 4 meters, 8 meters and so on. Up to infinite number. Then we should calculate the resultant intensity of electric field at x is equal to 0. What is the answer? Q by 3 pi epsilon naught be the answer here. Okay. Next one. See. For example, if an electron of mass 9.1 × 10⁻³¹ kg sent through an electric field of intensity 9.1 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb, then what is the acceleration produced by it? An electron of mass. What is the electron mass of the electron is given here? Mass of electron is equals to 9.1 × 10⁻³¹ kg. 9.1 × 10⁻³¹ kg is sent through an electric field of intensity. What is electric field intensity? Is electric field intensity capital E is equals to 9.1 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. 9.1 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. Asking acceleration produced by it. We need to find acceleration. Okay. An electron of mass 9.1 × 10⁻¹ kg is sent through an electric field of intensity. E value 9.1 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. Then what is the acceleration produced by it? Okay? See here. When, here what is the generally formula? F is equals to EQ. We may write F is equals to EQ but what is F is equals to MA is equals to EQ. Then from this equation, what is the expression for acceleration? A is equals to EQ by M. So acceleration A is equal to, what is the electric field intensity given? 9.1 into 10 power 6. And what is the charge of the electron? We know that it is given electron. Electron charge 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. And mass is given 9.1 into 10 power minus 31. Here 9.1, 9.1 get cancelled. What is A is equals to? 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 plus 6 minus 13 plus 31. That is 1.6 into 10 to the power of 18 meter per second square. 1.6 into 10 to the power of 18 meter per second square be the acceleration of the electron in the electric field of intensity 9.1 into 10 power 6 Newton per coulomb. Okay, next. There is a uniform electric field strength 10 cube volt per meter along the y-axis. Along the y-axis, let us take this is a y-axis. An electric field strength is equals to 10 cube volt per meter. 10 to the power of 3 volt per meter along the y-axis. If a body of mass 1 gram, mass of the body is M is equals to 1 gram. Okay? And charge 10 power minus 6. A body of mass 1 gram and what is its charge is 10 power minus 6. Q is equals to 10 power minus 6 coulomb, that is 1 micro coulomb, is projected along the x-axis. The body is projecting along the x-axis with a initial velocity of 10 meters per second. U is 10 meters per second along the x-axis. Okay. Then what is the speed of the speed in meters per second after 10 seconds? After 10 seconds we should find the speed. Okay. Now what is electric field is there along the y-axis? Okay, we are projecting the body in along the horizontal directions. Okay, the charged particle field is upwards, so it is normal projection. See, this is a direction of electric field. Okay. Now what is, when it is projected normally with an initial velocity, what is U is equals to 10 meters per second. The body moves in the, what is this is a positive charge, 10 power minus 6 coulombs, okay, 1 micro coulomb. So electric field is along the y-axis and charged particle is projecting along the x-axis, that means normally, and it can move in the parabolic path. The horizontal velocity remains same at every point. Horizontal velocity remains same. See, horizontal acceleration is 0. So horizontal velocity cannot changes. They are asking after a time interval of t seconds. After 10 seconds, t is equals to 10 seconds. What is its final velocity? Horizontal acceleration 0. What is the formula? V is equal to u plus at. Okay, a 0 means v is equal to u, that is 10 only, vx. Horizontal component of velocity remains same, which is 10 meters per second. But what is the vertical velocity changes? Listen here. Initial vertical Vy is equals to Uy plus At. Vy is equals to what is Uy plus At. Initial vertical velocity Uy is equals to 0. So what is Vy is equals to At? And what is A? Find the acceleration. A is equals to capital E into EQ by M. What is E? Electric field strength is given 10 cube. And what is the charge here Q? 10 power minus 6. And mass is 1 gram. Convert into kilograms. 10 power minus 3 kg. Okay? By M, 10 power minus 3. So which is equals to? A is equal to minus 3. Taken to the numerator becomes plus 6, minus 6 cancel. 1 meter per second square. Now we got acceleration. So Vy is equal to A1, time given 10. So what is a vertical component? Vy is 10 meters per second. Horizontal component 10 meters per second. But we need resultant. So velocity v is equal to, we may write vx I cap plus vy j cap. Magnitude of v is equals to under root of vx square plus vy square. Okay, that is under root of 10 square plus 10 square. Okay, that is answer is 10 root 2. The magnitude of velocity, okay, the magnitude of velocity after the 10 seconds of time, what is 10 root 2 meters per second. Means this is a problem related to the normal projection to the electric field. Electric field is along the y axis, but we are projecting the body along the x axis. So we know that already this topic is covered in the last sessions. Okay, it moves in the parabolic path. The horizontal component of velocity remains the same at every instant. And here we are neglecting the gravitational force. Okay, horizontal velocity 10. By calculating the acceleration, we are calculating vertical velocity Vy, which is also 10 meters per second. So find the magnitude. What is the magnitude? V is equal to, we got 10 root 2 meters per second. Okay.